Hello everybody and welcome to Muhammad Abu Sulaiman presentation. In this presentation we are going to talk about the giant kidney worm in dogs. Hope you all like it. So let's get started. First of all, I want to talk about the definition. So what is the definition of the giant kidney worms? The giant kidney worms, known as Dictyostomum renal, are a type of a parasite that can infect the kidney and the abdomen of the dogs. However, they are uncommon parasites in bed dogs. This is one of the largest parasitic worms known and can reach 40 inches in length. Female worms are bigger than males. Both sexes are blood red in color. They lay eggs that are barrel shaped and yellow brown in color. The urine of the infected dogs contains these eggs. Synonyms of this infection: Dictyostomiasis, Dictyostomiasis, giant kidney worms, kidney worm infection, Dictyostomum renal infection. Secondly, what is Dictyostomum renal? Dictyostomum renal, the giant kidney worm, is the largest known parasitic nematode. The nematode infects the kidneys of the domestic and wild fish eating carnivores. However, cases have been described in humans, and recently the parasitism occurred in a harbor seal. The nematode is comparatively more frequently observed in dogs than cats, horses, cattle, and other domestic animals. The adult worm is commonly found in the renal pelvis, but could be seen encysted within the abdominal cavity, the uterus, ovary, mammary gland, urethra, subcutaneous tissues of the inguinal region, and mesenteric lymph nodes. The occurrence of this nematode in different organs is directly related to the life cycle of the worm. Nevertheless, in dogs, the nematode has been more frequently observed in the right kidney and the abdominal cavity. Affected animals may demonstrate compressive atrophy of the renal parenchyma, dilation of the renal pelvis, and urethral obstruction. But most striking lesion is the progressive destruction of the renal parenchyma, leaving only a thin capsule containing the worm and hemorrhagic exudate. Thirdly, what causes Dictyostomum renal? The life cycle of the worm is very complex and includes intermediate, peritonic, definite, and or terminal hosts. Detailed descriptions of the biological cycle could be consulted. The life cycle of this infection: briefly eggs of Dictyostomum renal are passed in the urine and must be ingested by the intermediate host, which are aquatic oligochaetes, mudworms, where the nematode develops until the third larval stage. Egg development is fundamental for the biological cycle of Dictyostomum renal and is temperature dependent. Oligochaetes are then eaten by peritonic hosts such as fishes and frogs, where the infective larvae are encysted in tissues of these animals without further development. Definite hosts, wild fish eating carnivores, are infected by ingestion of contaminated oligochaetes or peritonic hosts. In these animals, the larva penetrates the duodenal wall, enters the abdominal cavity, and migrates to the kidney, where it remains until the adult stage. The mank muscular vision is considered as the principal definite host, while humans and dogs are terminal or accidental hosts. Since in most cases nematodes of only one sex are commonly found in these terminal hosts, with consequent discontinuation of the life cycle. Now talking about the pathophysiology. Dogs catch worms by eating infected raw fish, frogs, or certain common backyard worms, such as earthworms. Once a dog begins digesting the infected fish, frog, or worm, the giant kidney worm makes its way out of the bowels of the dog. into the liver and finally to the kidney. Often the worms do not make it all the way to the kidney and end up instead in the abdomen. Once the kidneys, the worms cause blockage and destruction of kidney wet tissues. The right kidneys is the one most commonly infected. If both kidneys become infected, kidney failure may result. Other problems that can result from this infection include inflammation of the abdominal cavity, bands of scar tissue in the abdomen or intestines, and liver disease. Symptoms of this infection. Adiactophyme renal infection is most commonly found after death. The carnivorous host often has no symptoms at all because oftentimes one's good kidney can serve the entire body. Not typical, but some dogs can experience renal pain, back pain, abdominal pain, hematuria, polyuria, weight loss, fever, inflammation of the abdominal wall, or lumbar discomfort. Diagnosis of this infection. Urinalysis may reveal proteinuria, hematuria, and pyuria. Ultrasonography or IV pyelography shows the enlarged hydronephrotic kidneys. The diagnosis is made by finding the eggs in the urine sediment. If both sexes of the nematode are present in the kidney and the ureter is patent, alternatively, exploratory laparotomy may reveal the diagnosis. Worms may be found in the peritoneal cavity, between the lobes of the liver, or within the affected kidneys via nephrectomy. Finally, you may feel safe in assuming that if your dog was to ever become infected with these worms, a trip to the vet would take care of it. However, the symptoms can be non-specific and general, that the giant kidney worms are never suspected. A urinalysis would detect the worms' eggs, which are passed into the urine. So if you suspect earthworms infected your dogs, tell your doctor and ask for a urinalysis to confirm. The problem is, however, that there must be a female parasite present for eggs to be detected. Even if detected, however, there is no known treatment. If one kidney is affected, the kidney can be removed. Sometimes an exploratory nephrectomy is performed, which involves cutting open the kidney to search for the presence of worms. Similarly, a laparotomy may be necessary to make sure worms are not infecting the abdominal cavity. And thank you for listening.